Synology Active Backup for Business makes it easy to back up and restore VMware, vSphere, or Microsoft Hyper-V virtual machines. What's more is that it's license-free, no matter how many VMs you back up. In this video, we'll show you how to create a virtual machine backup task and how to instantly restore to VMware, vSphere, Microsoft Hyper-V, and Synology Virtual Machine Manager, VMM. You will find the timestamps for each section in the video description. Before you start, install Active Backup for Business and Virtual Machine Manager on your Synology NAS. For a full list of compatible models and supported devices, visit the link in the description. To create a VMware vSphere or Microsoft Hyper-V backup task, launch Active Backup for Business. Go to the Virtual Machine tab, and then go to the VMware vSphere or Microsoft Hyper-V tab. Since the steps are similar, we will demonstrate using VMware vSphere. Click Manage Hypervisor. Click Add to connect to VMware vSphere. Enter the host information. And click Done. Click Create Task to launch the backup wizard. Specify a name and select the VMs for this backup task. To have new virtual machines automatically be added to the backup task, click Configure Auto Discovery and select the folders, hosts, or data centers where you want to enable it. Click Next. Configure the backup destination settings, and then follow the wizard to finish the rest of the setup. Click Done to start your backup. Active Backup for Business provides the following restoration options for different scenarios. When your essential services are down, you can choose Restore to VMware, vSphere, or Restore to Microsoft Hyper-V, and select Instant Restore to instantly restore your VM. This option temporarily stores the VM data on your NAS until the hypervisor is responsive. Then, you have to migrate the data back to the VM. On the other hand, through integration with Synology Virtual Machine Manager, VMM, you can restore your VM to your NAS, designating it as a temporary disaster recovery site while your VMs are down. This can also be used as a test environment where you can try out new upgrades without affecting the original production environment. All three methods provide support for both VMware, vSphere, and Microsoft Hyper-V. First, we will demonstrate an instant restore to VMware vSphere. Launch Active Backup for Business. And go to the Virtual Machine tab. Select the virtual machine and click Restore. Select a restore point and click Next. Click Restore to VMware vSphere and click Next. Select Instant Restore and click Next. Select Restore Mode and click Next. Click Done and you will be automatically directed to the Restore Status page, where you can monitor the restoration progress. Once services on the host are restored, the VM must be migrated to ensure full disk I/O performance. To do this, go to Restore Status and click Migrate VM. Next, we will demonstrate an instant restore to Microsoft Hyper-V. Launch Active Backup for Business. And go to the Virtual Machine tab. Select the virtual machine and click Restore. select a restore point and click Next. Click Restore to Microsoft Hyper-V and click Next. Select Instant Restore and click Next. Specify a name. Select a folder and click Next. Select a network and click Next. Click Done and you will be automatically directed to the Restore Status page, where you can monitor the restoration progress. Once services on the host are restored, the VM must be migrated to ensure full disk I/O performance. For instant restore to Hyper-V, this must be done manually. Refer to the Hyper-V migration article link in the video description for instructions on how to do this. Lastly, we'll demonstrate an instant restore to Synology Virtual Machine Manager. Launch Active Backup for Business. And go to the Virtual Machine tab. Select the virtual machine and click Restore. Select a restore point and click Next. Select Instant Restore to Synology Virtual Machine Manager, VMM. Select Storage and click Next. Configure the virtual machines you want to run on Synology VMM and click Next. Follow the wizard to finish the rest of the setup. Click Done and the VM will be imported into Synology VMM. In VMM, select a VM and click Power On to start up its services. Click Connect to open the virtual machine in a new window. Even if you restore your VM to VMM, you can still migrate it back to VMware vSphere or Microsoft Hyper-V later on in Active Backup for Business by going to Restore Status and clicking Migrate VM. To learn more about Active Backup for Business, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel or click on another video to keep watching.